Who's there? Max? Max, is that you? Max? Where are you, Max? Please. No, please, Max, no. I'm sorry. Please don't, Max, no.
The letter was staring at me.
Bartender is shiny stuff and dreams are made of stoop necromancers. He sings like a banana wrist, having strayed too close to the constellations on their shaved skulls.
It was a bad line and a prank call. Someone spouting insane babble, I couldn't make sense of it. But I had an overwhelming sense of deja vu. The caller's voice sounded oddly familiar. Piece of paper looked dangerous.
Don't lose it. It's Valkyr. The drug. Snap out of it. Try to remember.
It was a bad line and a prank call. Someone spouting insane babble. I couldn't make sense of it. But I had an overwhelming sense of deja vu, and the caller's voice sounded oddly familiar.
Max, something happened at the office today. A strange memo. Something about Vikings.
Honey, I gotta run. You can tell me all about it this evening.
Have a nice day, darling.
The bullet holes were rubies on her chest, blood glowing on her ivory skin. She was so beautiful. The killer was smiling.
The flesh of fallen angels.
Slowly, the green nightmare faded, leaving dark stains on my soul that would never come off. I felt like flatlining. I was all shook up. I woke up in a cold sweat, sick and tired to the bone, lying in a puddle of my own puke. The hag had said take me to cold steel before it had all gone crazy. It was a clue. The only one I had. It took me forever to crawl back to my feet and hit the road, but when I did, I drove straight to Cold Steel Foundry outside the city. There was a whole lot of action around the place for a freezing winter night. Trucks coming and going, men running. I had the drop on the mystery witch. She thought I was dead. I was on her blind side. I was going in. The bad trip had put me in a crazy mood, adrenaline pumping through my aching veins. Staggering on the mill roof in ice and snow and wild wind, I was a ninja. My kung fu was strong. I wasn't hitting anybody. At best, I was Superman on kryptonite about to fall through a skylight, down to where it was all going down. A half-abandoned industrial area in the middle of nowhere, the factory was a perfect front for any number of illegal activities. In the belly of the plant, molten metal boiled and bubbled like a witch's brew. Snow fell like confetti over the Devil's Parade. The storm was anything but over.
Come on. can believe it. How about they sleep with their...
No!
Talking military lingo could mean only one thing. They were getting ready to destroy the evidence and vanish into the night. I was so close. The hidden truths were just around the corner. Mercenaries were running a tight operation, paperwork and all.
Merchandise missing again. A chemist had tried to smuggle it out for his own private party. Locked him up in cell B7 and D6's old test facility to wait for proper processing.
I was close enough to hear the secrets, just beyond the next doorway.
Ah!
monitor showed me the way. Processing diagrams filled the control room screens, all but one. An elevator titled D6 on one of the screens, somewhere onwards, past rows of ovens, in the core of the plant.
Control destroyed. Repeat, under control destroyed.